Okay, today I thought we'd talk a bit about NAS drives and internet and IP addresses and all those sorts of things that people get a little bit confused about. Streamers are very, very popular nowadays. So what are they and how do they fit into the system? Well, what we've got we talked about in our whiteboard before was about the source being very important. Well, a source is really a streamer is just another source device. So I'll show a bit of a close-up of our screen here and just show you how this all works. So we've got the internet here, this big cloud, and we've got a communication between the internet and our router. That router will have an IP address. That's like a number like this that will be 10 dot something dot something dot something. So a series of numbers which identifies that particular item or its address on the internet. Then each device that connects to the internet also has an IP address. So let's say, for example, on your system, you have a series of IP numbers that start with 10.8.100 dot something. Those last digits will relate to the items that are sitting on your network. And so let's say our NAS is .135 and our PC is .134 and our streamer is .030. That's just an example of how the devices know what else is there. Now you need on a NAS drive to have some data. What is a NAS drive? Well, it's just network attached storage. That's what NAS stands for. Now, why would you not just say connect your PC into the system? You could just take an output from, say, the headphone socket and feed it straight into your amplifier. Yes, you could do that, and it will sound pretty awful. The reason is that computers are designed to do a lot of different tasks. So they're designed to number crunch. And they're very good at running spreadsheets and doing Word documents and all sorts of number crunching. And they're designed to do multiple different things. So they're the Johnny that's good at everything. And as we know, if you're good at everything, you're usually not exceptional at any of those one things, but you might be okay at them. Well, it's no different with your computer as a source device for your audio system. He's pretty good at doing the numbers, but he's not so good at putting out top quality sound. That's where the streamer comes in down here because the streamer has really good DACs in it. So how do you get your music into the system? Well, your PC here, if it has a CD slot on it, which probably if it's an older laptop it will, but if it's a new one it might not, so we'll look at that as a separate issue. But if it's got a CD drive in it, then you can take your CD disc that you have, your music collection, you can put it into this slot in your CD drive of your computer, and you can rip it. Ripping just means you're making a copy of it, and you can rip it and tell it you want it to store it on the NAS drive. So it will just store that data just like any other data. It might be a photo or it might be a video, it just happens to be an audio disc. And it will store that with the track information and with the cover art so that you can see the album cover and recognize that CD visually as you're scrolling through looking on your streamer. Now, the NAS drive, if you put all your data onto that NAS drive, how does it get seen by other things? Well, it has what's called a UPnP server on it. And that just means universal plug and play. It means that as long as the piece of software is sitting on your NAS drive that allows other items to discover it, it can be seen. So when you fire up your streamer, it will come up with a window and it'll say, well, here's your network and here are all the devices on it. And it will show your laptop and it will show your NAS drive. And then you can just say, oh yeah, I want to play music off my NAS drive. Go to your NAS drive and it will bring up all your music. Similarly, if you want to get anything that's sitting up on the internet here, it could be Tidal, Spotify, QuoBuzz, Deezer, any of the services that are running, like even the radio stations of around the world, thousands and thousands of radio stations, including Radio New Zealand and all the other Kiwi ones, they're all just sitting up there waiting for you to just access them from your streamer, because your streamer is connected to the internet. So it's a very simple setup. Why do the streamers and the NAS drives make such a difference to your sound though? Well, depending on how you ripped that CD, what quality level you decided to choose when you ripped it, will depend on what your quality of your source is like. And depending on how good your DACs are that convert that digital data back to analog, will depend on how good a source this becomes to feed into your amplifier. So the same principles apply that we talked about up here before, about having a good source and feeding it into your amplifier, and then you'd get a good sound out. The same principle applies here. If you rip your files as high resolution lossless files, and if you have a DAC that can transfer that information very faithfully to the amplifier, then you've got a good source. In fact, I would say if you rip it at the very highest level and you have a very good quality DAC, your sound can actually be better than the sound that was on that CD originally, because it's not being read in real time. Go back to one of my earlier episodes of the Lockdown Files, and you'll see that the quality can be better than a CD from a ripped file. So I hope that's been of use to you today. If you've enjoyed this information, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe down below. And we'll go into the other room now to listen to some music. Okay, here we have from 1987, the Dolphin Brothers. This music, it's a great clean recording, really good depth and plenty of punch in the bass, love the brass there. So yeah, Dolphin Brothers. Thank you. Okay, so some information from the Winter 87 Absolute Sound. I thought seeing as the Dolphin Brothers came from 87, we might as well go with an 87 Ab Sound. And here is a very interesting article from Auntie Enid's Remedies for Headshell Disease. Now, she goes into the sound there of all the different headshells and colorations that are unnatural caused by headshells, and then gets right down to the screws that had secure the cartridge to the headshell. And here's a little piece that's quite interesting. And I've found this myself, you can actually hear this, so don't dismiss it out of hand. Aluminium screws sound better, but still have their problems. Exactly what you hear depends on whether the screw is made of a harder or softer aluminium. But you will hear less of that upper mid-range forwardness and hyped-up transient response, and you will not hear hard peaky glares in your piano. With hard aluminium screws, violins still sound stridently aggressive and hard, but you no longer get that hashy grain in the tam-tam on Daphos that you get with the steel screws. And then it goes down to about nylon screws. They're a reasonable alternative if you're fed up with the metallic colorations in your music. However, they will blur detail in complex passages throughout the frequency spectrum. And then goes on to discuss about the mid bass and bass. So yes, every little thing makes a difference, even the screws you secure your cartridge to the headshell with. Also in this issue is an advert for the Magnepaner 2.5R and 3A, which was released in 87, and you can see there $1,550 a pair for the and here is an advert in that same issue of Absolute Sound for the Infinity IRS Betas, and the small little inset there is on the smaller model, the Gammas. I still have my pair sitting out in the warehouse there, all packed up in their crates. Still a great speaker today, some 30-odd years later.
Thank you very much for watching this issue 41 of our Lockdown Diaries. I'll see you on the other side for issue 42 tomorrow. Thank you for watching.
If you've enjoyed our videos, please click on this button here, which is the like button. And if you'd like to get notifications of future videos, then click this little one over here called subscribe, and the notification bell that comes up with it, if you can do that as well, you'll get notified of our next video. So thank you very much for watching. I appreciate your support, and I look forward to having you as a subscriber in the future. Thanks once again for watching.